It's still one of the most awesome images in history. Neil Armstrong descending from the lunar lander and becoming the first human to set foot on the moon. While many thought this giant leap confirmed a future of interplanetary adventuring, the reality is that human space exploration is mostly in our past. Nobody has even left Earth's orbit since Apollo 17 in 1972. However, after more than half a century, the future may finally be on the way, now that NASA has begun a new phase of space exploration, the Artemis program. To understand what's behind this new venture, it's worth examining why things ground to a halt, and that largely comes down to two factors: politics and money. You see, our first space expeditions were set against the backdrop of the Cold War, a four-decade standoff between the US and USSR. The space race was meant to demonstrate technological and scientific superiority, and the equivalent of hundreds of billions of dollars was spent in pursuit of that title. But once you win a race, you normally stop running. So after the US reached the moon in 1969, the motivation to spend buckets of cash on dangerous missions evaporated pretty quickly. And just 3 years later, NASA canceled all future Apollo missions, signaling the end of human space exploration, at least for a while. But circumstances change, and in the last two decades, launch costs have plummeted, while technical innovations have made sustainable deep space voyages more feasible than ever. What's more, in recent years, a new East versus West standoff has emerged. And while the original space race was neatly symmetrical, these days the field is far more crowded, with countries like China and India launching ambitious space programs of their own. Once again, the US and its allies can't afford to be left behind, which brings us back to Artemis. The first mission, Artemis 1, completed an uncrewed lunar flyby in 2022. The next two will be crewed by diverse teams of astronauts, including the first woman, person of color, and non-American to reach the moon, with Artemis 2 conducting another flyby and Artemis 3 making the first landing for 50 years. Eventually, the aim is to establish a base, which will serve first as a hub for lunar exploration and ultimately as a springboard from which to set off for the next destination, Mars. This is all really exciting because it's not just a return to the moon. It's a return to the spirit of the original space race, pushing the boundaries of human ingenuity and achievement. Unfortunately, though, it might also be a return to some of the less utopian themes of that period, like international rivalry and mutual suspicion. Except this time round, things might actually be even more precarious. You see, tense though the Cold War was, both sides nonetheless signed up to several treaties laying down basic rules governing space. No nukes on satellites, nobody can own the moon, that kind of thing. But with the new era dawning, now seems like the time to update that rulebook, which is why the US has proposed the Artemis Accords, guidelines for the civil exploration and use of the moon, Mars, comets, and asteroids, covering issues like releasing scientific data, preserving outer space heritage, and mining for resources. But while over 40 countries have signed the accords, others have rejected them, and instead drawn up their own agreements to build a moon base. Given those countries' relations with the US, that might not be surprising, but it is concerning, because it points to how much more complex the new space race is shaping up to be, something not limited to the international stage. A fundamental difference between Artemis and the Apollo program is how NASA relies on private companies like Elon Musk's SpaceX and Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin for launches, landers, and more. That's not inherently bad, but it does mean these companies, or more to the point, their billionaire owners, have real influence over national-level programs, without being subject to the same democratic accountability as governments. This is an entirely new dynamic, and we'll need to wait and see how it plays out. But we've already glimpsed the problems it could cause. In 2021, the Artemis program was delayed when Blue Origin sued NASA over a contract it didn't win. Given how much the world has changed since the Apollo days, it's obvious that 21st century space exploration is going to be very different, with a whole new set of challenges, but also new benefits. The first space race fueled advances in satellite technology, computing, medical treatment, and much more. It's no stretch to imagine similar innovations spilling over into our everyday lives. But as we set out on this new journey, aiming to go further than ever before and represent more of humanity in the process, it's important that Artemis should stand for something greater than just technological advancement, private profit, or geopolitical dominance. Instead, it's an opportunity to see ourselves from a global perspective and rise, quite literally, above our usual divisions.